Hello folks, and welcome back to another Keep Productive video. Today we'll be exploring Microsoft To Do versus Things versus Taskade. Now for this video, we've partnered with leading software comparisons site Capterra to help you make more informed decisions on what software you go with. You can use Capterra's wide variety of insights and reviews to help you improve your decision making. It is fantastic to have them on as a partner. And in today's video, I'm bringing together my own knowledge to review these applications. So let's dive in. Now, all of these applications are handy for being able to organize your to-dos and maybe even a little bit of project management flown in there. So let's get started. So let's begin with availability. Now, first off, Microsoft To Do is available on all devices and so is Taskade, which makes them pretty accessible. The only outlier here is Things 3, and it's made solely for Apple, which means it's only available on Mac and iOS. Now, when you look at pricing, these applications vary in pricing, but you're going to get Microsoft To Do for free with a Microsoft account. But do remember, if you're part of a university or work program, you'll be able to get that alongside all of the other applications. So if you look at Things 3, they have free pricing options: $49.99 for the Mac version, $19.99 for the iPad version, and $9.99 for the iPhone version. And those are all individual one-off costs, so you won't be paying a subscription fee as you go forward. Now, if you look at Taskade, it does have a very generous free plan, but it also has $5 per user per month for those who are really exploring some of the team elements of this application, which I think is fairly reasonable. So when it comes to features, Microsoft To Do is more of a personal to-do list application. It does have some great themes for customizing the way that you want things to look. And what I'd say is it's very good for a work situation to be able to share those smaller to-dos inside of a small team, and also good for the social situations, even perfect for students that are looking to organize what tasks need to be done inside of the house to keep it clean on a regular basis. But you've got great lists inside of this application and a feature called My Day, which is perfect for planning your day ahead and really simple in terms of its experience. When you look at this compared to Things 3, Things 3 is definitely the more advanced experience with a more personal to-do list application with no ability to share with other people. But you do get a great way to connect your Apple Calendar to it. And also you can plan projects inside this, which is great for those who are maybe freelancers or entrepreneurs or solo users. Now, if you look at Taskade, it does have some great personal plan, but it's really designed for small teams and it's got some great views. You've got mind mapping, Kanban, and lots more. And you can even take notes alongside it, which prompts you to, for example, use templates to be able to use it for journaling. And a lot of people like having that flexible layout to be able to add both tasks and notes together. So who are these best recommended for? I'd say Microsoft To Do is really perfect for those who like the Microsoft ecosystem, maybe who have a university and work account and want to be able to bring together their tasks. But this is a really simple to-do list application that is going to take you perfect experience for just planning a day or maybe even a short list of tasks to do. When you look at it against Things 3, I'd say Things 3 is much more perfect for those who are minimal, those who are iOS and Apple lovers, Mac users, and those who want to use it for themselves. It's got a little bit of a price to it, but at the same time, it's a gorgeous experience. I always call it the world's best design to do this application, and Things 3 definitely takes the punch for that one. So finally, let's look at Taskade. Taskade is really best for small teams. It's got some great collaboration features where you can collaborate in real time and even do a few video meetings. So it's actually quite helpful to be able to work together with other people. And it's also good for visualizing your thoughts using a range of different views. So I would say, if you're leaning towards this application, I would definitely use it in a small team if you have one, because it really takes advantage of all the functions. So folks, I hope you enjoyed this review of these applications. You can check out Capterra below, and also it has great insights in terms of reviews, so you can put these head to head and give it a real go in getting as much insight as possible before making that decision. So folks, a big thank you. I hope you found this video helpful. Make sure to subscribe to Keep Productive, and we'll talk to you very soon. Cheerio!